Welcome to this lesson, a shortcut for creating default and parameterized constructors in Visual Studio. After studying this lesson, you should be able to use a shortcut to create default and parameterized constructors in Visual Studio.
At this point, you've understood how to create a constructor and an overloaded constructor, but there's a shortcut that can really make that a little bit easier. And you understand that the constructor is what the new keyword calls. We also might just think of the constructor as a member function. It's the new member function in a class. And it's what gets called when a new instance of the object, a new copy of the working object of the class is going to be created. Okay, so we know that the compiler will create one by default. We don't have one, but oftentimes we really want not only the default, but we want a parameterized constructor that will allow us to specify the values that at the birth of the object are going to be assigned. So from the get-go, we have a useful object. And we don't have to go back and initialize the object before it's ready for use. We call it and initialize it all in one step, much more efficient. Okay, so here's a really quick way to do this. Refactoring widget has on it, when we select the class, an option to generate a constructor. There's also one here, generate constructor, and it has the name of the class. That's just going to be a plain Jane constructor. So let's create that first. That's no different than what the compiler would have created. So we can customize it if we want the default constructor to do some things. But there's no parameters. It just is going to use default values for everything. And that's fine. We probably should have one or have to have one explicitly if we're going to also have a parameterized constructor. So let's come back up here and let's generate a constructor. Now I'm going to call generate constructor, and it gives me the option. I can pick some of the members or all of the members to be parameterized. And I'm going to select them all in this case. Has an option that you can use to add automatic null checks. I'm not going to be involved in that today, so we're going to just take the simple case and say OK. And look, it's automatically built out the in order all of the property members of the class, and it's set them up to be initialized right off of the parameters, and so now we're all good to go, and we can call that parameterized function rather than having to first create the instance empty and then initialize it element by element. So much more efficient. This concludes the lesson.